Yo! What's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and today I have a very special guest with me. Before we get into anything, Jeffrey, why don't you introduce yourself? Tell the people who you are and what you do at Microsoft.
My name is Jeffrey Wong. I'm one of the inventors of DAX. I've been at Microsoft for more than 20 years already, primarily focusing on developing analytical engine features with a focus on DAX, modeling features like direct queries and composite models, all those complex stuff. I'm also working on AI and the DAX.
Wow. Okay, but today you're here to talk about something that people have been waiting for a long time. It's been out for a bit. You're here to talk about Visual Calcs. Why don't you tell us what is Visual Calcs, Jeffrey?
There are a new type of calculations introduced into public preview last year, and they're one of the fundamental new type of things that are tied directly to a visual, unlike all the other types of DAX calculations, like calculated columns, calculated tables, and the measures, which most of the DAX developers have been working on in the past years.
I've been writing DAX. DAX is so easy to write. But does Visual Calcs make DAX even easier to write?
That is indeed the biggest promise from visual calculations when we released them last year. People say, oh, DAX is hard, but that's not necessarily true. For example, I can define a total sales measure by summing over the amount column in the sales table. Similarly, I can define a total cost measure by summing over the cost column in the sales table. From there, I can define a profit measure by subtracting the total cost measure from the total sales measure. Defining filtered measures are also pretty easy in DAX. I can set a filter on the country column in the geo table to be United States and use that one to filter the total sales measure defined before and call that a US sales measure. So all these kinds of calculations are already easy to learn and define in DAX. But there are some so-called basic calculations that are surprisingly complex. To see one of those calculations, let's go to a Power BI desktop. Here, I have a small table with a list of dates and the values of a US sales measure I just mentioned. I also filtered this table to just January 2011 and formatted the results of US sales to just show the whole numbers to make it small and easy to see. You may notice that not all dates have sales in US. For example, there's no sales on the 8th, the 10th, the 15th, and some other dates. Let's say I want to define a new calculation. That is the difference between the value of US sales in the current row from the previous row. Basically, it's a row by row delta across all the rows. This is a very basic calculation in many reporting tools, like Excel can easily do it. But if I were to do it using a DAX measure, this turns out to be anything but easy. So Patrick, can you give me some ideas?
I don't know. I have to tinker with this a bit, Jeffrey. I'm not as good as you with DAX.
We all know that there are always many ways to achieve the same in DAX measures. And here is one way. Basically, in order to calculate this, we have to do it in multi-steps. First, I will calculate all the dates that are in this table. And then I will get the value of the date in the current row and the value of the date in the previous row. To do that, I will need to filter all the dates that's before the value of the current date and then take the max over it. Once we have both the values of the current date and the previous row date, we can calculate the US sales value in the current row and the US sales value in the previous row. And the last, if the US sales value in the current row is not blank, calculate the difference between the two. So as you can see, this is anything but simple. Let's drag this measure to the table. And let's just do a spot check to validate if that complex logic is correct or not. So on the first row, since there's no previous row, so the value will just be itself, correct? The second row, the value is the same as the previous row. The difference is zero, correct? The third row, the value is double the value of the previous row. Remember, we dropped the digits after the decimal point. So the difference is going to be the same value as the previous row, correct? And one more check. So the fourth row, the value is much smaller than the value in the previous row, so we get a pretty big negative number. The multi-step calculation indeed produced the delta that we wanted. So let's see how we achieve the same result using visual calculation. So I can right-click on this visual, new visual calculation is an option, and there is a list of templated visual calculations. I will choose the one that says versus previous. And now there is a pre-filled DAX formula that takes any field minus the previous of the same field. In this visual, I have US sales and then minus previous US sales. And that's it. Go back to the report. Since the default format has decimal numbers, let me just reformat it a little bit so it's easy for our viewers to compare. Go to properties, data format, choose the versus previous, and set the format to be whole numbers so it's the same. And now we can easily see that the visual calculation returns exactly the same numbers as the measure. This is clearly much easier than using the multi-step measure formula. It's because DAX measures are all independent and self-contained. The US sales delta measure is not aware that the values of US sales measure is already on the same visual and right next to it. Visual calculations, on the other hand, have access to both pieces of information. That's why they're much easier. But does it mean that for all such calculations from now on, I should not use measures? Not necessarily. So let me show you why. I'll copy this visual and paste it right next to it. Assume that I don't want to see the original values of US sales. I just want to see the calculated values. If I delete the US sales measure from here, I will get an error. That's because a visual calculation depends on the presence of those values. If I remove the visual calculations, you can see that the measure approach still works and still returns the same values as the one on the left. That's the beauty of using measures. They don't require the original values to be there. They can work out everything by itself.
So would it be a fair statement to say that visual calcs are not going to replace measures?
That's a very good intuition. Before I answer that question, let me first re-emphasize the main differences between the two. So what we saw so far is the measures are independent of visuals. They are not aware of what other columns or measures on the same visual. They are not aware of the sort order. They are not aware of the granularities. On the other hand, measures are tightly coupled with the underlying semantic model. Therefore, measure authors need to learn like a relationships graph. We all know that a poorly designed semantic model can lead to overly complex DAX unnecessarily. Therefore, a good DAX author must also be a semantic modeling expert. A good DAX guru must also learn some abstract concepts like role context, the filter context, the context transition. All those concepts are required for being a good DAX measure author. Visual calculations got rid of all those complexities and give users a very simple mental model. You can only work with fields that you can see on the visual. Therefore, you have much less columns or measures to worry about. What you cannot see cannot be used in your visual calculation, period. There is no relationships graph to reason over. There is no filter propagation rules to remember. And you can also access any values in any rows in the visual or in any granularities in the visual. For those people who are conscious about the performance of a query, visual calculations guarantee now to send any additional storage engine queries. With all these benefits of visual calculations, it's time to answer your question. The answer is absolutely. Benefit of measures is it's independent and self-contained. Therefore, it's reusable. The reusability is among the topmost reasons that people love Power BI. All the measures can be defined and stored and maintained in one place. They can be reused in any number of reports, including ones that the measure author is completely unaware of. They can be centrally managed, but yet provide a dynamic behavior. And also, this reusability is a key differentiator for DAX that is not available in any reporting tools that's based on SQL or Python. It can work with any intermediate values of any data types from any fields because it has a full access to the entire model. Unlike visual calculations, it's limited to only the fields already in the visual. So in the end, the visual calculations and the measures, they truly complement each other. And it's just another tool in the toolbox for Power BI users.
Since you brought up performance, if I'm working with a measure like the one we saw on the screen, and I don't need it outside of that visual, or I just compare the performance of the visual calc to the explicit measure that you created, should I see a boost in performance?
In the general case, absolutely yes. The visual calculations, as long as it's doable, typically only require simple measures to fetch the original values of some basic calculations and then working on top of that. On the other hand, for the measures, it completely depends on the measure expression and the DAX engine has very complex optimization rules, but there's no guarantee. So the biggest performance improvement from the visual calculator is going back to the simple mental model. You know exactly what is sent, what is not sent.
So I'm designing my model and I wrote that multi-step DAX query to answer the question for me, but then I realize I can do it in a visual calc. Would you say as a best practice, is it okay to have both the visual calc and the measure?
I would say if you can already do a measure, use the measure. Because again, measure has the reusability. It's harder to write for sure. From the end user perspective, it's a drag and drop. It's no longer complex.
Wow, what a whirlwind. This visual calcs. I really need to spend some time and try it out and kick the tires on it. Jeffrey, thank you so much for coming and spending time with us here at Guy in the Cube. All you who's watching, if you have any questions, if you have any comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about DAX or Power BI or different fabric workloads, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam,
Jeffrey,
and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.